What up? My name is Henrik, and I'm an artist with Next Move. All right, who is Henrik, man? I got a lot of different personalities. I feel like I'm that kind of person. A lot of people can probably relate to this, where like I'm really energetic and social sometimes, and other times I'm really antisocial and have anxiety and just want to be by myself. And I feel like that kind of comes out in my music, man. Like a lot of times I write about those low moments when I want to be by myself. I haven't really made a song about me being happy yet. It'll happen, man, maybe one day. But yeah, man, yeah, I don't know, man. I'm just Henrik, man. I'm just myself trying to follow Christ, and I'm trying to find who I am, man. And we're on the journey, and you guys are coming along for the ride, you know what I'm saying? So it's lit. Dropping my first song literally months before I had quit music because I thought I was trash. And, you know, my friends said I was trash, so I was like, all right, music's not for me. A few months later, God says make a song again, so I hop back in the game and go stupid with it, man. And it was just something I never thought would happen, man. And the ride from my first song to now, freaking about to have a song with a million streams, just blowing my mind, people. I don't really know what to tell you. You guys are the best for rocking with me. I love you guys. Ah, man, I remember I was at college and I had to drive 6 hours back to my hometown to record it, I recorded Stuck. That day, I remember, and then I drove back the same day. It was ridiculous. Now I've been fortunate enough to be blessed with a home studio, so whenever, you know, God puts something on my heart or I'm just feeling a certain type of way, I can literally just go and make a song about it whenever I want. It makes making songs so much easier and so much just accessible and real to me, so it's lit. It's dope. Yeah, being real and raw to me is the most important thing, because when I was growing up, that was the kind of music that impacted my life the most. Like, I remember all the artists I would listen to, the things that always stuck with me and impacted me and helped me on my walk with Christ were the songs that were just real, vulnerable, and they were unashamed about it. They didn't care what anybody thought about them. And I remember like middle school me, high school me sitting, listening to a song about, I don't know, like porn, or listening to a song about just struggling. It just made me feel like I wasn't alone, and like, you know, I could grow, and it was just, I don't want to be that person for somebody else. I remember in high school, man, dropping SoundCloud songs that impacted absolutely zero people, and I never thought there would be a day when my music actually meant something to anybody. So now just seeing like all the DMs that I get every day and the comments and everything that you guys send me makes me emotional sometimes, man, and it keeps me motivated, and it's one of the biggest reasons I do what I do and make the music I make. So thank you guys for the messages, man. It means a lot. Performing at Holy Fest, yeah, it was only my second time ever performing. It was my first time with like a pretty good sized crowd. And I did not expect anybody there to know me at all. I was just gonna go up there and try to do my thing. But as soon as the first song started, man, everybody was singing the song and knew all the words, and it was unbelievable, man. Cause I remember going to shows, going to Christian rap concerts in high school, and I would be in the front row trying to get the artist's attention, singing all the words, and there was dudes doing that for me, man. It was, I don't know, man. I don't know how to describe it, bro. It was crazy. Unbelievable. Unreal. Creating this EP with Coop and Chris has been a very crazy experience for me. I had never made music with any other person. This was my first time working with anybody in real life, and Coop and Chris are much different artists than me. Like, they're very versatile, but they have different sounds than me. So I was really kind of nervous when we first started working. Like, the first couple sessions was kind of awkward for me, and I didn't know where I fit in with the group and with the sound. But the more we got to know each other and work together, the chemistry just slowly built, and we started to click on all levels, man. Just sonically, spiritually, and just being bros, man. And the stuff we ended up cooking up, man, I'm really excited for you guys to hear it, man. It's something, man. So yeah, I'm hyped. It's been good. Yeah, man. The main thing I kind of want to leave with all my listeners, the main reason I make music is like, life is really hard sometimes, guys, and your walk with Christ is not always gonna look the way you want it to. You're gonna go through a lot of struggles. You're gonna fall into sin. You're gonna doubt God. You're gonna wanna walk away from God. But at the end of the day, that's just the reality of life, and God is there through it all. And it's just up to you to seek Him out, man. So yeah, He loves you, so. That's all. That's it, man. That's it. My name is Henrik. Thanks for hanging. It's been real. Love y'all. I'm out.